All right, I'm back. I'm gonna take apart this water pump. May not really do too much, but take off these bolts up top and this thermostat housing. Then I can clean up this. I can clean them all up, which I'll do that tomorrow. It's a little too late to make a lot of noise. I could if I wanted to, but it's a weekday. I'm trying not to disturb my neighbors. Otherwise, I'd be out there banging on it right now, putting this water pump seal in, but I could do it tomorrow. That's a motivation to get the garage clean enough to pull a car in here, which might be a while. It's happened before. I had a Mustang 5.0 in here before, and I changed my clutch in it. I was actually closed the door and everything. I don't think I could fit the Caprice in here, but you know, you could actually pull the front end in, but that's a long time from now. Anyway, here's these pieces right here, and I'll clean them up on the wire wheel tomorrow. I'll just leave them there for now. There was no thermostat in here. All right, next I'm gonna take this water pump sensor, coolant temperature sensor out. 19. That's a direct fit, y'all. And it comes off with ease. Nice. So I guess you don't have to take it off on the car. I will have to. I feel like I put thread locker on there and then I probably took it off because I probably thought it wasn't reading. You could tell that there was some on there. Anyway, it wasn't leaking. I don't know if it was reading or not. That's a whole nother story. There, that goes with the other stuff. So there that is. This one, that was spinning way freer right there. I don't know how they're supposed to spin, but this one is like way freer. I don't know. The other one, the new one is like, it's spinning freely, but it's just not as, this one's just like, I could spin it easily with my hand. I have the other one there, but my hands are dirty. I'll have to show that another time. I'm not trying to get it dirty yet. You can kind of see the inside here. I don't know what that means. It does look kind of rusty in there. It doesn't look bad though. It was still working. I really don't know if you guys can see. That's an interesting shot in there. Get off of there. I can't see on my camera anymore because it turned black, of course, but you guys should still be able to see in there somewhat. It looks like it works still. It does work still, but it's a little rusty, but it wasn't needing to be replaced yet. It's just looks a lot worse than it probably is. At the same time, it's probably been on the car for a number of years and didn't have a thermostat in it, so it's all that. There's a new one right there. And these are different for the Firebirds and the Trans Am. I mean, the Caprice Impala versus the Trans Am ones. You know, make sure you get the one for the car you got, or else these things will be pointing different directions. You probably could use them, but you might not want to. All right, so that's good. Let me get this out of here now. It still works if anyone needs a water pump. All All right, I guess I'll clean this up right now. I think I need to put this in the sink or something, or spray some carb clean or something in there. It's looking pretty nasty. I'm just gonna fix this. I'm just gonna clean up this outside part right now. I just put the water pump seal in. I just don't know how much I want to do right now, but this does need to get done, so this is easy enough. I might want to sand this down, the bottom part. It probably doesn't matter, but really polish this up if you wanted to, but I'm just cleaning it because this looks so good and this is like, whoa, you know. I'm gonna take this to the sink and clean it up in there, see if some of this water residue wants to come out, or maybe I'll spray it with the carb clean instead. Get these up. Yeah, that thing's trying to get away from me. Come on. Old toothbrush to get me in there like that. Whoa, look how nasty it is. A lot of it will get cleaned up just off the water, probably just letting it soak. I'm not sure if this is rust or if this is the orange colored coolant. I think, I'm pretty sure my car uses the orange coolant. I mean, I think it comes all colors now, so I don't know. And I haven't changed the coolant or flushed it or done anything. I just got the car how I got it, so I don't know if everything was correct or if it's rust or what we're dealing with. But this is probably just overkill what I'm doing here, but hey, well, it's in my face. And if I'm putting the brand new thermostat in there, it'll make me feel a little bit better just to know that it's clean and stuff. Because, and then you could just go extra far with like SOS pads, like this SOS pad, this thing. All right, if you want to go all the way far, you could sacrifice an SOS pad. And an old toothbrush. That gets nasty. I mean, it's getting there, but don't brush your teeth with that one. All right, I was just gonna do it. I'm gonna do it like I'm not taping though, even though I am. This is one of those moments that this Caprice has needed for so long. I don't know where to clip it. That's gotta go. It wasn't really doing much anyway. It just, I made it obvious that the car was a bucket. The radiator sits where it wants to. It's like, whatever. I can't go nowhere anyway. It's just chilling. Yeah, that had to go. Got the water pump bolts. Yeah, I'm pretty much gonna put this, I don't know if I was gonna do it right now, but I guess I could, kind of. I got this water pump. And I got the thermostat. And I'm pretty sure it just sits up, I'm pretty sure it just goes up in there like nothing, you know, like, hey, that's where it is. Make sure it's all nice and legal. Guess those are welds right there. I'm just making sure it belongs together, y'all. Probably would get a napkin. Yeah, let's get a dirty one already. Start dirty. Well, I'm just doing it just to get any grease or anything out. Maybe it should have some. I don't know. I think it'll be all right. Yeah, so that just goes in there. And that's it. If I'm doing it well, I'm doing it correctly. Then we need this piece. I shouldn't mind that it's wet. We're getting used to that. And we need these. And what size are these? I forget. A 10? No, a 8. We'll get most of it going here. Don't believe it needs any type of sealant or anything. It just goes on there like it's supposed to. As long as it's heading in the right direction. Is it? I don't think it wants to go that way. These are like an 8 millimeter. And of course I don't have it with me. Yes. There it is. Do it evenly. Actually, you can just take that off probably. Do it hand tight, I guess. You don't have to put any sealant on here because that O ring, it has a nice seal around it on the thermostat. And if you notice you're leaking, I guess you could tighten it more. I wouldn't over tighten this because then you could crack the housing and then you got to go to pick and pull and get another one. And I don't want to do that. That should be perfect. This I have loose right here. This is a bleeder screw. And I'm going to have to remember to open that and bleed it. All right. Next we have, yes, I forget if I put any. Teflon tape on there or not. I mean I did put some, but then I took it off. I think I can't remember. It definitely had some residue. I want it to go like that. Now I got it. So it doesn't come undone when you screw it in. It's not perfect either. I doubt it's gonna come all the way out anyway. Probably the only two threads that matter are the first couple ones anyway. Anyway, there it is, y'all. Don't pay attention to me. Feel like they said like maybe don't put that in because it might make it hard to read, or sometimes the temperature doesn't read if you put that in, but I don't know. Better safe than sorry. How far is this thing gonna go in now? I want it like even. I don't want it all weird. I feel like that's even. It's not going anywhere. Could it be more tighter? I don't know. Nah, it stopped right where it's supposed to. Alright, we got that, we got that. We tightened that. Next step is put this water pump on, I guess. I think that I'm gonna have to get some type of Permatex or something. I didn't flush the cooling system. Thin film of sealer. Rubber gaskets only. For rubber gaskets, only use silicone grease. Sealers will cause premature failures of a rubber gasket. Yeah, oh, okay. I need to find some type of Permatex. I wonder if I should use these or if I should use the ones, the Felpro ones. I guess we'll be looking into that next. Now I just gotta, put a thin coat of sealant on both sides and put it on. Cannot forget to put this shaft on there. And then we'll be almost there for real. I feel like I should use these Felpro gaskets. We'll see which one. Let's see if they're the same shape. I mean, I don't know. They're definitely the same. They're definitely the same shape. Probably. I probably want to use the Felpro ones. Maybe. Let's see. This one feels harder. They're exactly the same pretty much. I probably should use the ones that came with the water pump, so it'd be nice and happy. I should put it on. Why didn't I get that correct? Like that. Nope. Like that. I'll probably use the ones that came with the water pump. So just need the sealant now. Probably don't have any. I mean, I probably do, but it'll probably take forever to find it, and so I probably should just go buy some, but I really don't want to. Alright, so I'll be back. Alright, this thing goes this direction. This groove goes towards the engine. Kind of feel like putting a little grease in there. I swear there's like a million jobs to do on this car. I don't want to put too much grease because it'll come flying out because this is going to spin around. But I feel like maybe it should get a little something in there. Just to, I don't know. If that much comes flying out, then whatever. I mean, you could work it in there with the screwdriver, I guess, if you wanted to. Better than nothing. Maybe. I don't know. But it goes that direction. That groove goes towards the engine. It sits closest to the engine block. I don't know why. That's what it says. That's what people say. That's what I saw manuals say. And that's probably how it came off my car. If not, that's how it's going back on. Probably doesn't matter, but I like to just do what it says. All right, next step. We're gonna put this water pump on. We're gonna put this water pump on right now. I'm looking for some type of something. All right. Let's get some light in here, I guess. This is as good as it's gonna get. I'm gonna put some number 2 non-hardening pliable sealant, Permatex. We shouldn't need a lot of it. No matter how much I put, I'll probably put too much, but whatever. Probably too much, whatever. Whatever. Let's do the other side. What's better? Not enough or too much? I feel like it's more for keeping it put than actually sealing it. All cars are different. Some require no gasket maker stuff. So just make sure you read the directions and know what you're doing for your car. That should be good. Probably too much. I don't know. Now, this side gets it too. Kind of push this down some. I tried my best, well, maybe not my best, but I cleaned off the surface on the engine so it's ready to go. If it's gonna seal, I want it to seal around these water place ports. I'm not trying to come up short there. Probably putting too much. Anything else will come back into the system. You don't really want that. But I just don't want to come up short on it. Oh, what to do? Okay. I think we're doing all right. Let's do it one more time. Kind of dabbing it on here. Oh, that's too much probably. When it push it on, it'll compress and squish all around the sides, and you'll say, oh, about to put too much. Pr- probably better to put too much than too little, but I don't know. I mean, yeah, if it leaks, that's a problem. I guess I'll be doing it again. I mean, I feel like that's gonna seal all the way around. Don't know what else to do about it. The place I worry about the most are around the ports, of course. It looks good. Don't know what more I could do for it. That doesn't look good. I think it does. Don't want to wait too long and let it dry here. Probably should put some. I'm gonna have all this mess up my new water pump. So I'll put some new gloves on to not destroy the water pump, I guess I will. Since we're going all out here on this job, it's almost done. Make sure we're recording. Yes, Mike, I'm out here. There it is. Get up close and personal. Yes, this is going on there, and then I can quit for the moment. That'd be the last dirty part of the job, I think. Probably won't be, but maybe it should be, I don't know. So let's go. These bolts are all cleaned up, ready to go. Got one on each side. And I'm gonna aim for, I think I'm gonna put it in the top. Put one on each, the top. And we gotta align this. Let me see. It might be easier if I get these out of the way for a second. I'm not sure. Let's see. Is that right? Let's go in. Yeah, maneuver yourself. Oh, and they got those little tabs the water pump will sit on. At least it should. Oh, the problem we're facing right now is trying to get this to line up. Oh, I'm stuck. Let's see. Let's try again. I gotta move this water pump. So it can fit, it can line up with this. There it goes. Nice. And let's put this top one in. I should have had the right size. Just waiting. But what do you know? I didn't. What do you know? What do you know? It's actually going in. Let's get this one in too. Feel like one of these goes through the water, the bottom one, and maybe I should put some type of sealant on that. should also have the torque wrench out here as well, but I don't. This one, that one's the same. Short ones all the way to the left. This one's the bottom. This one with the stud is all the way to the right. And then you would usually put your air pump bracket on that. I don't have that on my car. And so I'm not going to be putting that back on. Alright, that's on there. I need to torque it down to 30 foot-pounds. We'll get it hand tight for the moment. I'm still gonna tighten up these balancer bolts, probably with my air ratchet, unless I use my regular ratchet now that I got this belt on there. I'm gonna focus on this right now. All right, that's 30. I mean, I got it set at 30. I'll crisscross it. Let's go to this bottom one over here. That's 30. Let's go up top of this one then. Nice. Let's go over here to this bottom one. Nice. Let's go over here to this. Oh, we need a deep one. Alright. This is the piece I'm looking for right here. So I can... This piece goes off a deep 3/8, 9/16. Then I could put this on the torque wrench. And I could torque this last one down. All right, they're all at 30 now. I'm gonna double check and make sure that's supposed to be 30 and not higher than that. I don't have any coolant, and I have to put my hoses back on. I'm gonna put my green hoses on, so I gotta do that. But that right now has a water pump on it. Looks way better. I just gotta remember where I had these lines going. Have to watch some videos, my own videos. I think that one just went on here. That one probably went on there. Probably pretty straightforward, like they are in front of my face. Oh, I don't know, could have been reversed. Nah, that one probably went up like that. And that one probably put down like that. Yeah, that looks about right. Just trying to figure out things here. Getting very close. Now I just need coolant. I'm gonna get the orange coolant, I'm pretty sure. The Prestone, I guess the 50-50 mix, because unless I get the straight orange one, I got distilled water, so that's nothing. Yeah, gotta go round up these hoses. Probably be done for the day. I just wanted to make it so the next time I come out here, I don't gotta get super dirty. And I think I got everything covered. I'm gonna have to zip tie some of this action back to safety. Make sure that it doesn't hit. There's gonna be a whole bunch of that going on. Oh, let's plug this back in. Oh, I should do that cleaner. Right, I guess. Everything's so dirty on this car. Now we can finally clean it a little bit. Horribly dirty this car is. Alright. Which one does this? Alright, that's on there, that's on there, that's on there. Alright. Maybe I should put this on just for fun for right now. I don't want it to forget where it came from. Well, that's pretty dirty. That's how you make your new water pump look nasty. I don't know if I have these hoses, and also these go to like the heater, and I don't have the heater hooked up at the moment, so that's that. All right, I think that's it for right now. A clean up, and we're getting there. We are getting there, pretty much there.